This API combination will probably give you the fastest voice chat inference that is possible, and why I had to slow it down. Hey, can you tell me about yourself?
I'm an AI assistant trained to provide helpful answers and assist with tasks. I'm here to help you with any questions or topics you'd like to discuss.
Can you tell me your name?
I don't have a personal name, but you can call me assistant at AI assistants if you like.
Can you pick a name for yourself?
How about Ada? It's a nod to Ada Lovelace, often considered the world's first computer programmer.
That sounds good. Tell me a joke.
Here's one. Why did the computer go to the doctor? Because it had a virus.
That's a good one. Can you summarize the conversation we had so far?
We met, I introduced myself as Ada, told a joke, and now I'm summarizing our conversation for you.
In the last video, we saw an implementation of the system that I demoed today using OpenAI services. So we collected our audio using the microphone, then used a whisper that was running on OpenAI API to get text transcription that was fed into GPT-4o, again using the OpenAI API to get a text response, and then we use the OpenAI voice engine to generate the final audio. However, in this video, we are going to replace the OpenAI services with a combination of Groq and DeepGram. These are probably the fastest APIs available for their respective use cases. So first we'll get the audio, and we're going to be using Whisper that is running on the Groq API. The Groq team was kind enough to give me an early access, so I was able to do this, and this is extremely fast. So we got the audio, converted it into text, then we're going to be using Llama 3 8 billion version, again running on Groq, to get a response to the text input from the user. And then we'll use the DeepGram text-to-speech converter through their API to generate the final audio. Now, when I was using this, DeepGram was unable to actually keep up with the Groq speed, so I had to do a couple of hacks. I'll walk you through those. Now, before showing you the implementation, let me show you how fast Whisper is on Groq compared to OpenAI. Okay, to do a speed test between the Whisper available through OpenAI API versus Groq API, I took the transcription of a Spring Update video, which was used to introduce the GPT-4o model from OpenAI, and this is about 30 minutes audio. Then I used the OpenAI API to generate transcription for this audio. So here's the implementation. If you have seen my previous video, you have probably seen this code. So we're using the Whisper 1, which is the latest model currently available through OpenAI API. And then we just provide the audio file and we get the transcription. Now the total time it took for this whole process to complete is about 67 seconds, which is pretty impressive for a 30 minutes audio, given that it's not running locally, but we are making an API call. But then I use the Groq API. So the way you set up is you create a Groq client, then using that client, we're going to be using the audio transcription endpoint, and they're running Whisper Large version 3. You provide your audio file that we converted from the video. Now, this took only about 24 seconds, which is almost one third of the time that the OpenAI API is taking. So this is extremely fast. Now, for smaller audio segments, you may not feel the difference, but for larger audio files, the difference is definitely more prominent. Okay, and for the text to audio conversion, we are going to be using DeepGram. DeepGram is a service that provides you text to speech as well as speech to text. You can sign up. They give you $200 when you sign up. So basically, you can use this for absolutely free. Okay, so when you sign up, you can create your own API key, and then you can use that on your own projects. So let me walk you through the code. Okay, so here's the code. It's structured exactly the same as I showed you in the previous video. If you haven't seen the previous video, I will put a link in the video description. But let me give you a quick high-level overview, and then we're going to look at more finer details. So first, we have a function that converts our audio recorded through the microphone and save that to a test.wav file. Then we use a model to transcribe that audio. So in this case, we're going to be using the Groq API with Whisper running on top of it. Then we're going to use the Llama 3 8 billion model running on the Groq API to generate a response to the user query. And at the end, use the DeepGram API to generate the final audio based on the response that we get from the model. And just like the previous video, we are keeping track of our chat history. Okay, now this code is going to be available on GitHub. Just give me a few days to clean it up, put everything together. This is going to be open source and is going to be available for absolutely free. I saw some comments on the previous video around it, so don't worry, I'll make it open source. Okay, so first we need to create a .env file. Here you want to put all your different API keys. If you're using the OpenAI version, you want to get the OpenAI API key. If you're running the Groq API, you'll need to get that, and you'll also need to get the DeepGram API. Okay, so once you have that for the Groq version, we first use the getENV function to get the API key. We create a Groq client. Here we are initializing the chat history. So initially the system role is you're a helpful assistant. Your answers need to be short and concise. Then we need to create a client for DeepGram. So we'll get the API key. Then you need to set some options. So DeepGram offers multiple different voices. If you're using the text-to-speech converter or API service. So we selected one of the voices. But here is the list of all the voices that are available. So there are some female voices, some male voices, and you just need to select the voice that you like. So just select this text and put it here. Then for encoding the audio, we're going to be using linear 16, and the final output is going to be a WAV file. Okay, so this is just setting up both the Groq client as well as the DeepGram client. Now, I'm not going to walk through the details of the code for the functions that were used in the previous videos. So record audio is exactly the same as the previous video. Now, for the transcribe audio, this follows exactly the same pattern. It just replaces the OpenAI API call. As you can see here, we're just replacing that with Whisper Large version 3. So that will give us the user input in the form of text based on the audio that we just captured from our microphone. We append that to our chat history. So that will be the user input and the role is user. Then we generate a response. We will be using the Llama 3 8 billion model served on the Groq API to get a response to the user input. Okay, so we get the response. We append it to our chat history as assistant response. Now we need to convert only the response that we got to speech. And for this, we're going to be using the DeepGram API. So we get the text that the user provided, and then we make a call to the DeepGram text-to-speech endpoint. This will generate the final output and save it to disk. But you will notice that I was actually putting the process to sleep before making call to this text-to-speech API endpoint. And the reason is that Groq responds so fast that if you don't put some buffer time in between, the output audio generated is going to be shorter than the actual audio. So it's still something that I haven't figured out, like how much time I have to wait before I actually make the call to the API to convert the text to speech. But this is something that you need to play around with. If you don't set, for example, this buffer time, you are going to generate full responses from the Groq API, but the audio that you get is usually like a part of it, just like the last part, last half or a quarter part compared to the full. So this is something I'm still trying to figure out, like what is the best parameter combination in terms of like sleep time, and I'll update the code when I have some good default values. Right, so we can create this audio output file, and then we just play it on the speakers or through your headphones. Now, if you want to do some cleanup after every pass, you can also delete these files if you want. But the system works pretty nicely. Okay, if you're using Groq Whisper to transcribe your audio, keep in mind there is a rate limit, and you can quickly run into issues with the rate limit. But I hope as they scale up their infrastructure, it's going to be much better compared to what it is right now. But right now it's absolutely free. So everybody is using Groq for free. So you can't really complain about these rate limits. But something to keep in mind if you're testing it and you run into that issues. Another thing is when it comes to DeepGram, it's a paid service. But as I said, when you sign up, you get $200 credit, which is pretty amazing because you can use these services for absolutely free. And these are state-of-the-art models and at absolutely crazy speeds. Okay, so this was the second video in a series on creating voice chat assistants. In a follow-up video, I'm going to try to use local models. I haven't really found a great combination, but I'm experimenting with a few options, and we're going to create a whole local version of this system. So if you're interested in that, make sure to subscribe to the channel. I create a lot of videos about RAG if you're interested in that. There's a course coming pretty soon. Make sure to sign up for that. Link is going to be in the video description. And we have a pretty helpful Discord server. So if you want to learn more about what I'm doing, plus the community you're just doing, I highly recommend to check that out as well. Thanks for watching. And as always, see you in the next one.